I did 5 grams of magic mushrooms with my gay best friend. And a lot of you guys might be wondering, Mario, why the hell would you ever want to do this? I'm in a weird place in my life right now. I'm transitioning into a woman. I just looked down and I was like, you know, it's not that far off. I might as well just... A lot of things are happening right now. You know, I'm transitioning from being a model to now being a comedian. A lot of things are changing in my life. I just proposed to my girlfriend. I want to have this experience where I can learn something about myself. And my best friend, Travis Bryan, who's been featured heavily on this YouTube channel, there's even a photo of us hanging here in this room where we're oiled up as oil paintings. He's been struggling with depression. Do you maybe have seen it on YouTube? It's actually the reason why he stopped making YouTube videos.
You've played such a big role in helping me through like the shit that I went through. I don't know why I'm going all heavy with this, because now this is gonna make me cry.
The one thing that helped him in his life, more than any therapy, more than any pharmaceutical drug, was psychedelic drugs. So I was like, you know what, Travis? Give it to me, daddy. And I did 5 grams of magic mushroom. My friend Travis was there to babysit me. First of all, this is not medical advice, I'm just sharing my experience here, right? But 5 grams of magic mushrooms, it's a lot of magic mushrooms. I was laying down, and he banged me. Fuck! Stop. We didn't bang. I can't just fucking tell a story without making a joke about banging Travis. I, before doing this experience, was afraid. I know so many people who do a psychedelic experience like that, and it changes their entire life. I was afraid that I was gonna figure out that I'm supposed to quit social media and become a gardener. Or maybe I'm supposed to break up with my girlfriend and become gay. I was kind of joking with Travis. I was like, bro, what if I come back from this journey and then, you know, I realized that it's been you all along and that we're supposed to be making more naked oil paintings oiled up together. Fucking fuck, fuck, fuck. So with that in mind, I embarked on the journey. I put on an eye cover, meaning I couldn't see anything. Anything that happened was purely based on myself. So it's really the intention of this experience is to go inward. It is not to go out and see some fun visuals. It is truly to go and confront your trauma. And I have a lot of things I haven't fully resolved. Primarily my relationship with sex. I'm pretty much asexual. I don't like having sex and I was raped by somebody. So I was like, let me actually go into that. And I feel like I'm in a stage of my life right now where I'm very stable mentally and I'm ready to learn more and really confront myself. So I lay down and I listen to the shamanic music. And to make this short, I had what people call an ego death. I, as a person, Mario, did not exist anymore. I saw myself dying. My ego, me as the person I am, the German alpha male, beautiful, hung, young little stallion, big stallion I am, did not exist anymore. I died. Like, I truly felt like I was no more. And the interesting thing is that I did not really care. It was this beautiful realization that I don't fucking matter. And I don't mean this in a condescending way. Like, you don't matter, dude. In a grand scheme of things, we are a freaking poops. It's a fart in German. We are a poops in the history. And I had this realization, and it's not even a thought or an idea. It is like, I know that we're all one. It sounds very like, Mario, you're such a like vegan now, you're such a little simp boy, you're such a little soy boy. Almost every person that's got to that level has experienced the same thing, and when everybody experiences kind of like the same thing, there must be something to it, you know? It's like, it's just science at this point. We are all one, but we have our egos that kind of separate us. And then I had one of the most impactful moments of the experience. I saw myself on stage doing stand-up comedy, which is what I love the most in the world. There was a guy in the crowd who was not connected to me in the real world. In my mind, he was like a Middle Eastern dude, gold chains and a baseball cap. But when I told a joke on stage and we laughed together, in that moment where I looked into his eyes and we laughed and shared a moment of joy together, we became one. Not in a sexual way or anything. I told him a joke and I banged him behind a trash can. I was like, yes, we have won now, yeah? In that moment of sharing joy with somebody, it breaks down all the things that separate us.
Through joy and laughter and being silly, we connect.
Yeah.
Even though we're a different race.
It's so powerful too, to be able to have, break through someone's ego to make them laugh. That's
like, yeah,
the thing that we were saying.
Because that's what I think, because we're
like
all
a shell that we all create to,
exactly,
like, separate ourselves from each other, to create that
illusion,
that we're,
yeah,
separate.
That we're separate, yeah.
And then you are able to penetrate through that through,
yes,
like comedy.
Humor is connecting us. Joy is connecting us. And I thought about the moments when I felt most connected with my parents or with Travis or with Vita. It's always when we share a moment of joy, because that's the purest expression of what we're supposed to be doing on this planet.
Joy is honestly the most connected we can ever be. Mm-hmm. And you know, a lot of people think of connection in terms of love and even sex, but I thought, think of it in terms of like laughing together.
Yeah.
And then I went into the dark parts of myself. All of a sudden my stomach started hurting, right? I started literally contracting. My stomach was like contracting. I didn't eat much before, and you're literally poisoning your body with 5 grams of mushrooms, right? So I went into the moment when I was raped by this dude. I walked towards the thing I'm afraid of. I don't want to get too explicit, but I saw everything that happened. I saw this guy while I was drugged, and he was like, you know, just like, you know, just like. But there was, oddly enough, such an acceptance around that. And listen, this is gonna sound like fucking weird, but with the realization of that we are all one, when I saw him banging me, it turned into this weird morph figure where I was him and he was me, and then I saw him banging himself. And it's this realization that at the end of the day, whatever we do to other people in this lifetime, we do this to ourselves because we are all one. And I laughed so hard about this. I realized that there is silliness and fun in anything, and that's the power of comedy, especially stand-up comedy. That's why I believe we should be able to joke about anything, because that's how we cope with things. I saw myself on stage one more time, and I was at an orchestra, and I had a little wand. This is not like an actual character, but I saw all the darkness, like the rape and everything happened in my life. It was like a dark cloud that was really heavy, and I pulled up that cloud, and it was almost like I was casting a spell or something, and I was using the wand, and I lifted up the wand, and the dark cloud came up with the wand. What the, shut the fuck up, there's a fucking, I'm telling, this is the climax of the fucking video. I hate that there's always these fucking sirens in LA. I'm trying to film a video here, god fucking fuck, fuck! And then I started playing a note as a composer. And the moment I started playing a note, the darkness became light, and it became a song that was shared with the world. Holy fick fatamtish. I truly understood that we all gonna have dark things that happen in our lives, and we can choose to be victims and we can be consumed by the dark cloud, or we can transform it and make it into something beautiful.
There's nothing more beautiful to imagine just than the imagery of seeing that darkness shift to light.
Yeah.
We can turn darkness into art, and that's what I'm doing with stand-up comedy, because I realized when I told the story about being assaulted by a guy, what happened because of this negative incident, something beautiful came out of it. So many people are commenting every day, telling me how it inspired them to be more vulnerable as men, to speak up about things that happened to them. And it created so much connection, so that I have to say, at the end of the day, being assaulted was something positive. That was one of the most powerful realizations ever, that it is almost like my responsibility to tell this story and to write about it on stage. And I'm currently working on a whole stand-up bit where I'm gonna tell the story of how I was sexually assaulted on stage. And the whole thing took about 4 or 5 hours, and Travis was checking in on me. He wasn't present. He was basically in the other room jerking off or something. I don't know what the fuck he did. When I came out of this experience after 5 hours, I open up my eye mask. And then people always say you should never look in the mirror because it's gonna freak you out, you're gonna look weird, you're gonna realize how ugly you are, you're gonna have a third eye. And I turned to my left, and Travis had a mirror right next to the bed, and I looked myself in the mirror, and I just realized how fucking hot I am. Like, I get why this dude raped you, all right? I get it, dude, I get it.
I was like, this guy is fucking hot.
And then when Travis noticed that I was taking off the eye mask, he came into the room, and I still like had my eyes closed, and I was still very out of it. And the first thing that I saw when I opened my eyes, I saw Travis Bryan with his beautiful eyes. And the first thing he said, he leaned over to me and he whispered in my ear, and he said, "Welcome to homosexuality." And I started laughing so hard.
Because when we just laughed together after, when I found out I was gay.
Dude, I laughed so hard, and it's like, I think there's nothing more pure than that connection. We're never more one.
Yeah, exactly.
Than when we laugh together, you know?
I can just feel it. I can just feel that connection.
The fun Travis and I had and the connection we have is unbelievable. And just like, that's so Travis to like make a joke like that after I just went through like the fucking 5 hours of the most profound experience of my life. And then Travis looked at me and he was like, "You know, Mario, I knew you'd be a fine homosexual, but I had no idea how good you were gonna be." It almost was so reassuring that with stand-up comedy and being silly, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing on this earth. I don't fucking know if anybody cares about this shit. Let me know if you had any experiences, if any of this stuff resonated with you. Make sure to subscribe to the Carrot Kingdom. I love you, and I'll see you next time.
I love you.